The Senate has directed three joint committees to investigate how the $1.2 billion loan collected by Etisalat Nigeria was spent. The decision of the upper chamber was a sequel to a motion sponsored by Senator Adeola Olamilekan on the need for the Senate to intervene in the company's debt crisis. He noted that the loan was acquired in 2013 as medium term with a 7-year facility to fund the expansion of the network from a consortium of 13 banks.
Note that as of 2016, the company has started defaulting on its $1.2 billion loan obligation, leading to a full bailout from its parent company in Abu Dhabi. Understand that about 42% of the loan has been repaid, remaining an outstanding debt of $696 million, representing 58% of its capital, which Etisalat has failed to service since 2016. Understand that since this year, the bank has been moving to take over the telecommunication company in order to recover their funds. Note that the Nigerian Telecommunication and Central Bank of Nigeria have intervened and raised issue of regulatory compliance in trying to prevent a takeover by the banks, but the intervention has failed to produce an agreement on the debt restructuring. Observe that all UAE shareholders of Etisalat Nigeria, including the state-owned investment fund Mubadala, had exited the company, coupled with the resignation of top key management officers of the company. The Senate is convinced that if this situation is not properly handled, it will have a negative implication for the Nigerian business environment and on foreign investment in Nigeria in general.